I know one has realised I'm here, it's unbelievable. Of course, the spirit of racing here in full effect. Great here for the final race of the season as well.
I'm no live on Facebook.
A good friend of mine, Andre Corey. You're a bit far down the grid from what I'm used to seeing you. What happened?
I was just a hand of bad luck, I'd say, but feels us to jump off the path, and hopefully, you know, we'll have some good battles. Come up and come to it.
What's the club link like here for you this weekend?
It's pretty different from the one that we're usually used to. It's a challenge, so it's not good done, yeah.
The final sector here. It's got quite a bit of elevation and there's some quick corners to see it. What's it like going through there quickly?
I mean, like, you have to hit it properly. If you're not hung up on the barriers, you can see there's a lot of scratch marks there. Right? But you just need to be consistent when you're taking the turn, you're pushing back down onto the power.
Thanks so much, Andre. You started a bit further away, but watch out for these guys here to charge their way through the field. Let's go back up to the sharp end of the grid because I know David Bright is somewhere. Faisal Astalawi is here as well, of course, the general manager of the Dubai Autodrome. Although, no, that's not Faisal, that is David Bright is here though. And it's quite busy at this side of the pits. Not the pits, we're on the grid, aren't we? The pits are on the other side of the wall here. So let's go back down to where Fairly Motorsports are as well. And you can see if you can talk to anyone else here. I see Harry Hannum is here as well, raced eSports over the summer break, was racing a few weeks ago as well at the hashtag NoFilter DXB during their eSports tournament as well, promoted from pole position. And how many minutes to go we've got? Oh, we've got 10 minutes. We've got plenty of time to walk around and to talk with some of the drivers. So we found, someone has nominated us to talk to a driver here. You've been nominated to talk to me, and I'm pretty sure you don't want to. You're probably getting in the zone here because you're going to start the race here. What are your thoughts going down towards turn one here for the first time?
Let's try. It's going to be tough in starting from the bottom of the grid, but we will try to manage and pass so hard as I can for the team. And also, I would like to thank Chief the invitation, and I'm sure all nice appearance to the guys. I'm very glad to raise my hand today.
In all fairness, you've got quite a good position here, because if there's calamity going through turn one, you've got a prime position here to stay out of all of it, don't you?
Yeah, we'll try to use the inside line, and hope to avoid any crash. So,
good luck. I mean, side for the back isn't the best position, but let's see how these guys pan out. So, of course, very tough from there, but at the same time, it's kind of like a coin flip here. It could be good, it could be bad, and it could play out. Well, we'll find out in about 10 minutes' time. Now, let's see, there are plenty of drivers here. He says a lot of them already discussing future plans, of course, drivers getting ready to start. I think, you know what, I'm going to see if I can speak to young Harry Hannum, who's done a lot of esports here, and Harry with his team. Harry, what's it like transitioning online from, say, Gran Turismo, Race Room, a couple of weeks ago, and you're now in a car here for a 24-hour?
That will be not easy to drive.
Feels great. The hill. My mate.
No.
Can't wait to be
No way.
Yeah.
You have to sit down.
All of these here are your
teammates. Because last year we got penalty 20 seconds.
Really?
Yeah.
So who's starting the car? You're starting or...?
Greg was running and hitting the gas, 20 second
penalty.
So be careful.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Sari, for speaking to us. Of course, they'll start sort of towards the end of the field here, and Martin's throwing me off. No, Martin, I want to stay.
This one is so
cool. Oh, okay. Martin's telling me everyone has to leave the grid. So if you're not starting the car, please make your way off the grid. And before we go, let's see if we can get a quick word in with Faisal or David, because they're all the way here at the tail end of the grid. I say that because they're actually at the front of the grid here, and I see Faisal has the Emirati flag in hand, and he's actually talking with Fernando Alonso.
So for those of you who are not starting the carts, if you can make your way off the grid, we have 5 minutes to go before we start the race. Let's see, maybe you can talk to David here, of course, the organiser of our fourth round. It's quite an impressive one. We've got 28 teams. We've got an impressive talent pool here. You must be happy for this final race of the year.
He's not waiting 85.
No? Yeah, it's a great turnout considering the travel restrictions.
Yeah, maximum is 30 kilograms.
So he's less than 55.
Yeah. So it's a great turnout.
You have to cut my arm, then I'm like 75.
Yeah. This one. I have 1 kilogram here.
You are live on Facebook.
Yes.
Yeah. So a real mix of international talent here.
Good luck.
Today.
Yeah, good
Big
luck.
Thanks to our sponsors.
Came to me and follow me if you can.
I try.
All our go to the front position.
Powered by EDC. So we look forward to it, and hopefully in 24 hours, the right team wins.
See, 24 hours is quite a long time, as one of the carts is escaping already. He wants to get the race started already. That was car number 15. And I think, is it time for us to leave? How many minutes have we got left? We've got 5 minutes left, or can we? So 5 minutes to left. If you're not a starting any of the carts, or if you're not a car, please leave the grid, because we want to get underway at exactly 1 o'clock. There's one final picture to be taken here at the end. We've David and Faisal, and of course Fernando Alonso in the middle there too. So we're about to get underway here for our final round of the Dubai Kart Rally Endurance Championship. This of course is round four, and then we will, after 24 hours, we'll figure out who's won, not just the 24 hour, but of course the Dubai Kart Rally Endurance Championship as well. So I'm going to make my way off the grid, because it looks like it's just going on at the moment, and I don't want to be that guy. So I'll take a quick break, and then we'll we can talk about the first couple of laps of the race.
Oh, is Lord Fernando doing the side?
What?
Not Fernando doing the start?
No.
Uh-huh. It's too dangerous.
It would be not like cheating.
Oh, yeah.
If you do it, it would like look like cheating.
Yeah.
But they came in, and the last lap, and they had a very good guard.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. You know?
Yeah.
Five rows and a sixth one.
Yeah. This was clear, to be honest, from the beginning.
Yeah.
Something like that will happen for sure.
But he said also to me, don't look about those because my team is not so good.
Okay.
He directly said you will hit him.
Mm-hmm.
So we're just about 2 minutes to go before we start the 24 hour here. And what a grid it is, we've had from David Wright already. We've had 28 teams with drivers heading from all over the world. Drivers flying in just yesterday. Unfortunately, a few teams couldn't make it here. But of course, we have 20 teams, and over 100 drivers here this weekend. Some teams doing with four drivers, some doing with six. So we're about to get on the way here for the Le Mans style start.
He has to manage everything by himself.
Round four.
He has to manage everything by himself.
Car number 25 receives, well, not receives, but gets a penalty because they will start from the back of the grid due to underweight in the sprint race. And of course, we did speak to one of the drivers from that team way back there. Now, again, it's kind of like a situation where they're in a good position or they're in a bad position, because yes, they're at the back of the field, but if anything that happens through turn one, they have the most amount of time to react to it. And of course, they can benefit the most. Of course, well, they will benefit the most because they're starting at the back of the grid. Any position gained is a benefit for them, isn't it? But we're about to get underway. About a minute and a half to go before we start the 24-hour here, our most intense and grueling race on the calendar. We've had a series of 12 We've had at least two 12-hour races, and one that went slightly over 12 hours as well, of course, because it was a lap duration race. But here we go for a timed race, another 24 hours. One full day of racing will start at 1 p.m. today, and we'll finish tomorrow at 1 p.m. 1 minute to go, 60 seconds on the clock here for the start of the Mike Archer Endurance Championship round number 4. It's about to get underway. We can barely contain our excitement here at all. The drivers are preparing themselves to sprint across the track. As we said, on the Monster start here, they'll run from one side, jump into the other, and hopefully they'll get a good getaway and quickly overtake their rivals in front of them. We'll have MD Racing on pole position. The Stop and Go Racing team just behind them. Tony Sport by Raynald. Paul's fantastic one. Big Gap Racing rounding out the top five here at the Dubai Kartrope for the start of our race. A 24-hour race here. Here we go. The seconds ticking down before the start of the race here. Faith Marsalawi, the general manager of the Dubai Kart Autodrome, will wave the UAE flag at the end to signify the beginning. And he has flag in hand. Up in the air it goes, and he waves, and we're racing here officially for the next